Hi, my name is Dr. Njira Lugogo, and I'm a professor of medicine at the University of Michigan.
Hello, everyone. My name is Jean-Pierre Llanos Ackert. I'm a pediatric pulmonologist and an executive medical director at Amgen. We are here today to talk about the fall peak asthma season and why it's so important for physicians to have a conversation with their patients with severe asthma about their level of symptom control. So to kick us off, the first question, Njira, would be, when is exactly the fall peak asthma season, and what can patients with severe asthma expect to have during that season?
The fall peak asthma season occurs every year as the seasons change. And in the fall specifically, you will have higher levels of indoor and outdoor allergens, dry air, pollen. And unfortunately, our kids start going back to school. They start getting respiratory viruses, which they bring home. And so all of these things together increase the risk of patients having severe exacerbations. It can start as early as August and continue through mid-October, but really it's the most likely to occur the third week of September each week in the US. And that's really where we see the highest concentration of asthma attacks and ER visits and hospitalizations.
What would you tell your physicians? How should they care patients with severe asthma, and especially in the fall peak asthma season? What should they do to be prepared in anticipation for the season?
So the first thing is to, you know, figure out where your patient is. Are they controlled? Are they uncontrolled? And to identify severe asthma patients. Actually, the vast majority of these patients are in primary care. Or if you have a patient that is really reliant on high doses of inhaled corticosteroids in order to remain controlled, that's a patient that actually has severe asthma. And then lastly, anybody on maintenance oral steroids is sort of like a very emergency type situation. If you have maintenance oral steroids, those patients really need to be seen in subspecialty care.
Njira, thinking about the patients you treat in your practice, how many patients with severe asthma think they're well controlled while actually they're uncontrolled?
If I took a patient that hadn't already been seen and came to me for the first time with severe asthma, many of them really don't recognize the severity of their disease. And in fact, when you use the word severe asthma, they're often surprised by that. I can tell you many don't understand the immunology of the disease. They just aren't really aware of what the issues are that are causing their symptoms. And more importantly, apart from under-recognizing their disease, they have extremely low expectations of what can be accomplished in terms of controlling their disease. And so maybe that's really where we need to educate our patients. Of course, we want them to recognize that their disease is severe, but maybe it's more important to recognize that you don't have to accept that you have to live a certain way.
So which kind of questions or which additional assessments do you do to identify if the patient really has control or uncontrolled disease?
Now, in my own practice, I rely on patient-reported outcome tools. So every patient does a questionnaire. There's also something you can do called the Rules of Two, which basically asks the patients whether they've had quick relief inhaler use twice in a week, if they've woken up twice in a month at night due to asthma symptoms, and also if they're refilling their quick relief inhaler more than two times a year. And then really what we need to do is talk to our patients about what good asthma control means. And I think when I describe what good asthma control means to my patients, most of them are actually quite dumbfounded by it, because they believe that using your rescue inhaler a few times is not a problem.
Any last message or takeaway you want to communicate to your fellow colleagues or healthcare practitioners who treat patients with severe asthma?
Peak week is just a really good opportunity to perhaps catch some of those patients that maybe don't come in very often or that don't report a lot of symptoms. It's really an opportunity for us to hone in on asthma patients and really start thinking about the people that might need a different strategy and approach. So I think we need a call to action where all of us come together to basically say it's unacceptable. for patients in 2024 to suffer significantly from asthma because we have the tools that we need to help these patients. And so I'm hoping that Peak Week is just the beginning